All right, we're here today with Taylor and Nicole, and we're going to learn the welding, MIG welding. We have some instructions in front of us, and MIG welding is also GMAW, gas metal arc welding, and this is basically what it's doing. This is Taylor's first day out here. So we're going to go over the basics, and then at the end of the day, we're going to let them do a little bit of welding. So basically, this is what the gun looks like. So it's basically creating an arc. And you got your wire that comes through the gun, and it arcs in between the piece of metal that you're using, and it kind of melts it. So it melts the metal that you're working with, and it also melts your filler metal, which is inside the welding machine. We'll go over that in a little bit. So this top sheet here has a lot of good information. And I'm gonna get back around so I can actually see what it's saying. All right, so the first part is short circuit transfer. Operating range for steel, low voltages and 16 volt to 22 volt. Low amperages, 30 amps to 200 amps. Wire electrode size, smaller diameters is 0.025 to 0.045, and in millimeters that would be 0.60 to 110. Shielding gas to use is either 100% CO2 or 75% argon and 25% CO2 gas mix. That one right there is the one that we use. Now, why do we use, does anybody know why we use a shielding gas? Why?
Because it basically, as you've explained to me before, it makes a dome around it, and that's how it welds, and the gas creates a weld. And then the metal kind of bleeds a little bit, and the triangle here is the dome around the weld of the gas.
Not quite. Okay, the gas comes out of the nozzle right here, okay? And let's try to speak up because we got the camera here. The gas comes out of the nozzle, okay? So it creates like a shield, okay? So it gets the oxygen away from where the arc is happening between the metals that are joining together. So the operating, the shielding gas is the different kinds of gas. We use 75-25. That's what's in our bottle over there on our welder. Get back around here so I can read what we're reading. Operating range for the steel. It's pretty much the same thing. Shielding gas, that's for globular transfer, short circuit transfer. All right, pulse spray transfer. And this is just the ranges that it uses for the pulse spray transfer and then spray transfer. We're going to be doing the short circuit transfer. Now, over here on the right-hand side is this, you're gonna get used to seeing this graph right here. That graph, and that's not to scale, but that graph is how you're going to, that's how you're going to see how to set up your machine. Yeah, that's still a little bit warm. I'll put on the glove before I touch that. All right, so, like I said, it's not to scale, but that's some pretty thick metal right there. And we're probably not going to be welding metal this thick with our MIG welder, but it's what we're going to do the project with today. It's the scrap metal that we have. So you would take a measurement here and then convert it into decimal point, or some of the graphs have it into half inch. So I believe this is half inch. So that would be 12.55 millimeter or 12.5 millimeters. And then on the hood of the machine, it will tell you how to preset your machine and give you a good starting point to where, know where you're at. All right, so any questions on this sheet?
Nope.
Okay, let's move this out of the way.
Very educational. Oh, my favorite.
All right, this is, let's come over here. This is for stick welding. We're not doing stick welding today. Today we're doing gas metal arc welding, or GMAW. Or MIG welding, as we're gonna call it here. You have two different methods. You have a push method and a pull method. So when you take the gun Okay, pretend my finger's the gun. You can either push the weld or you can pull the weld.
Taylor, do you remember that little plate with the initials on it?
Mm-hmm.
That was a pull weld because I pulled it towards me.
You pulled on that one, but you can also do push, and you're going to do both of them unless you're going to have two initials. You're going to have your first initial and your last initial of your name. So on one, I want you to try pushing, and on the other, I want you to try pulling. All right, so this is A. So can we read what A says?
Proper wire feed speed, WFS. Voltage, electrical stick out, that's proper too.
And travel speed.
Okay, so that means that that is pretty much what we want our welds to look like. Okay, see, everything's consistent, everything's the same, and you can see where they finished up, it kind of pulled up at the end. All right, Taylor, why don't you read this?
WFS to slow.
All right, what does WFS stand for?
Proper wire feed speed.
Okay, so wire feed speed was too slow. See how it kind of pulled up on the side and it had splatter on the side?
Mm-hmm.
That means they were moving the gun too slow, or the electric. All right, so C is what? Nicole, read that.
Wire feed speed was too high.
Okay, now what do you see on that?
That one is uneven and there's no splatter that I could see, but it's pretty uneven.
Right, and it's just kind of sank into the metal a little mm-hmm. bit. All right, read that one, Taylor. What is D?
Electrical stick out, too short.
Okay, so that means that you had the gun really close to your piece of metal. So you want to keep it about 3/8 to a half of an inch away, okay? And you can see. But if you get it too close, you run the risk of it, sticking
splatter.
To each other. And, well, splatter is going to be, there's a lot of factors on splatter, but yes, that could be one, I reckon. You want to keep it about a half inch. So you don't want to be touching your metal. You want to be off of it, but you don't want to be back here. Okay? So you want to have your gun to where you're about a half inch, and maybe we'll just do little back and forth motions to start with. Okay? Which one were we on? E?
The D doesn't look that bad compared to this.
It doesn't, does it?
No.
I wonder why. Maybe somebody can answer us why. It may be just the way we're looking at it. It may be that it didn't put enough material down.
And actually, if you look closely, it has these little bump things. This D is pretty smooth except for the end.
Yeah, it's probably just didn't put enough metal down.
Okay.
It burned it up so quickly that it didn't have time to really penetrate. Without the heat marks, I really can't see that well. All right, E. Nicole, read E.
Electrical stick out ESO too long, and that one looks terrible.
Yes, so that means basically it's going to sound like sizzling bacon. Like bacon sounds like it's just crispy, crispy, crispy. All right, if the stick's out too far, it's going to sound like pop, 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 pop. It's just not going to give you a very consistent.
And I think I've actually done something that sounds like that.
Yeah, I mean, we all have. I mean, sometimes you're trying to you get your head around to where you're trying to see, and you lift the gun up accidentally. You're not always going to be in the most perfect spot. All right, Taylor, read F.
Travel speed too slow.
Too slow. Travel speed was too slow. So that means the distance from the material was right. Oh, I guess right here. Look, this is the other view. All right, so D. Okay, so you see the difference between A and D?
Mm-hmm.
See how this one's a little bit taller and this one just kind of melted into it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's why that one isn't as good. But D looks pretty decent to me. So we're on F. Travel speed was too low. Look at the sides, okay? See how it doesn't really flow into the piece of metal? It kind of just blobs on top and it just kind of looks...
This side flows, but that side doesn't.
Yeah.
And there's a tad bit of
it just, yeah, it just didn't have... It wasn't very consistent there. So we're gonna try and do A, but we're all three of us gonna be probably somewhere in the middle. All right, Nicole, read G.
Travel speed too fast, and that one is skinny.
All right, and it didn't have very much penetration. Can y'all see that little loop down there on the bottom of those?
Mm-hmm.
See how C is way down in the metal?
Yep.
And then G just barely goes down in there. It wasn't really bonding the two metals together that well because it didn't have enough time where it needed to be.
I think that G is kind of in the middle of A and F if you look at the size of the weld.
Yeah, it just wouldn't it wouldn't be that strong. Yeah. It wouldn't, you didn't put enough metal, you didn't put enough material down from the welder, and you just went way too fast. You didn't have time to heat it up to bond all the metals. All right, H, go ahead, Taylor, read H.
Inadequate gas coverage.
Inadequate gas coverage. That means that you forgot to turn the gas on, or there you ran out of gas. A lot of different reasons can be why that could happen. But then if you start seeing that, and you'll notice that within a couple inches, that that's starting to happen, stop. That way we can look at maybe we're out of gas, maybe the gas wasn't turned on, because we will get in the habit of turning our gas on and off whenever we're done welding. That way we don't waste the gas. All right?
H and E look kind of similar, don't you think? There's
H
a little bit of bubbly.
And E. Yeah, okay, so what's the difference between H and E? Okay.
This one's a little bit thinner and a tad bit straighter. And this one, and thinner.
All right, well, the shielding gas, remember what I told you about the shielding gas? It heats out the contaminants. It gives it an atmosphere that's just right for welding, okay? But you notice that E, the stick was out, so it started popping, so it wasn't sounding like bacon. So that's the difference between E and H. Now, it'll give you similar looks. However, they look totally different. This one's really piled up real high. It just put all the material on top of what you're trying to weld, and it just didn't look that way. All right, y'all have any questions on that one?
Nope.
Okay, let's go to the next one. This is going to be our assignment for today.